Class 5 IMO Level 2. Achiever section question number 46. Find the difference between the area of shaded part and unshaded part of the given figure. Now do not scale. In order to find this, let's first divide this figure into rectangles. This part is rectangle 1, rectangle 3, rectangle 2, rectangle 4, rectangle 6 and rectangle 5. Now that we know all the sides of the rectangle, we can find the area. Here are the areas listed below from rectangle 1 to rectangle 6. Now, total area of shaded part is equal to half area of rectangle 3, that is 12 square centimeter, plus half area of rectangle 4, that is 12 square centimeter, plus area of rectangle 5, that is 12 square centimeters. The total is 36 square centimeters. Now total area of unshaded part is equal to half area of rectangle 3 plus half area of rectangle 4 plus area of rectangle 1 plus area of rectangle 2 plus area of rectangle 6, that is 60 square centimeter. Now the difference between the unshaded and shaded part is equal to 24 square centimeters. Achiever section question number 47. Study the given abacus and clues carefully. Clues. Interchange the tens place digit with hundreds place digit and ones place digit with 10,000s place digit. Now, first the number given in the abacus is 65,382. Now, after interchanging the digits, the new number formed is X. Now, based on the information, we're gonna now select the correct option. The new number formed is greater than the original number. This is false because the new number formed is lesser than the original number. Rounding off the original number to the nearest thousands place will give us 65,000. Yes, this is true. Rounding off the new number formed to the nearest hundredths will give us 25,800. Yes, this is also true. So, B and C are true. Achiever section question number 48. Observe the given figure carefully and select the correct options. There are 3 intersecting points in the given figure. No, there are 6 intersecting points in the given figure. Angle POW and LOR are both acute angles. As we can see here, POW is an obtuse angle, not an acute angle. So we need not check LOR angle. There are 2 pairs of parallel lines. Yes, this is true. The 2 pairs of parallel lines are XS, YR and ZULT. There are no pair of perpendicular lines. No, the perpendicular lines are LT is perpendicular to WQ, ZU is perpendicular to WQ. So, the option which is actually correct is the third option. Achiever section question number 49. The given bar graph shows the number of ACs sold by a company during the 6 months of a year. Study the given graph carefully and answer the following questions. First one, if the number of ACs sold in June was twice the difference between the number of ACs sold in May and April, then find the number of ACs sold in June. First of all, ACs sold in May is equal to 3,500. In April, 2,500. Twice the difference of May and April is equal to June, that is 2,000. Second question, out of the number of ACs sold in August, 520 of them were damaged and were returned back to the company. Find the fraction of number of good ACs sold in August to the number of ACs sold in July and March together. Now first, the number of ACs sold in July and March together is 5,000. Good ACs sold in August is equal to the number of ACs minus the bad ACs, that is 2,730. Now, the fraction of number of good ACs sold in August to the number of ACs sold in July and March together is equal to 273 by 500. Achiever section question number 50. Read the given statements carefully and select the correct option. Statement 1. The sum of 15.912 and 28.125 and 18.683 when rounded off to the nearest tens place gives 63. Now first let's find the sum of these. The sum of this is equal to 62.72. When rounded off gives 63, so this is true. So statement 1 is true. Now statement 2. The difference between the shaded decimal part of the given figure is 0.25. Now the shaded part of figure 1 is equal to 9 by 12. Shaded part of figure 2 is equal to 6 by 12. and the difference between these two is equal to 3 by 12, which can also be written as 1 by 4 or 0.25. Since they have asked it in decimals, we are converting fraction into decimals. So statement 2 is also true. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.